Hey, what's up guys, welcome back. In the previous video we created the rotates sphere script, and now in this video we will write the program to rotate our spheres. So below this rotate sphere class, I'll first declare a data type called vector3. I'll give this a variable name of movement. I'll put a semicolon. The vector3 data type accepts x, y and z values as input. After declaring the vector3 data type, next I'll initialize it inside the start function. So inside the start function, I'll write down movement and I'll set it equal to new vector3. I'll then open and close round brackets. And inside these round brackets, we have to enter three values for x, y and z. So first, we'll just move the sphere along the x-axis. Okay, so I'll just give a random value of 30 for x. I'll then put a comma, and now as you can see, we are getting these two values of float x and float y. So we have set the x value to 30. After this, I'll set the y value to 0. I'll again put a comma and I'll set the z also to 0. After this, I'll put a semicolon. Okay, and on line number 9, I've finished initializing the vector3 command. After this, inside the void update function, I will write down transform. Okay, now guys, please make sure that you select the transform command which has a small t over here. So I'll select the transform command. After this, I'll put a dot, and after the dot, I'll write down rotate. Now guys, using this rotate function, we can rotate any game object. Okay, so I'll select the rotate function. After this, I'll open and close round bracket, and inside the round bracket, I'll write down movement, okay, which is the variable name of our vector3 command. Okay, after this, I'll just put a semicolon. Okay, and as I was saying, with this line of code, our sphere will rotate, and the sphere will rotate along the x-axis for the time being, as we have stored an x value of 30 inside the movement variable. So guys, after this, I'll save my script. After saving the script, I'll minimize MonoDevelop, and after this, I'll select the rotate sphere script and I will attach this script first to the sphere one game object. Okay, so I've attached the script to the sphere one game object. So if I click on the sphere one game object and if I go inside the inspector panel of the sphere one game object, then as you can see, the rotate sphere script is attached to this sphere one game object. Okay, so I'll save my Unity scene, and after this, if I click on the play button, then as you can see, this sphere is rotating. Okay, so if I go inside the scene panel, then as you can see, this sphere is currently rotating along the x-axis, and the name of the sphere is sphere1. Okay, so guys, since we have just attached the rotate sphere script to the sphere1 game object, the sphere1 game object is only rotating. But you can notice one problem over here. And the problem is that the sphere is rotating very fast. So I'll come out of play mode, and next I'll again open my rotate sphere script, and I'll multiply this movement code with time.deltaTime. So this time.deltaTime command will basically give smooth movements to our sphere. That is, our sphere will rotate smoothly now. So I'll save my script, and this time if I click on the play button, then as you can see, my sphere is rotating very smoothly. Okay, so this sphere one is rotating smoothly. Next, if I increase the value from 30 to 150, and if I save the script, and if I click on the play button, then you will notice that the sphere will now rotate a little fast. So guys, these values which we are entering over here basically represents the speed at which a sphere will rotate. Now, currently we have just attached the rotate sphere script to a sphere one game object, okay? But I want all the spheres to move together, okay? So next, I'll select the sphere one game object, and I'll first remove this rotate sphere script from the sphere one game object, okay? So with the sphere one game object selected, I'll go inside the rotate sphere component. I'll click on the gear icon neighboring to the rotate sphere script, and I'll click on remove component. Okay, after this, since all the four sphere game objects have been created from a prefab. I'll go inside the prefabs folder, and after this I'll select this sphere prefab. Next, I'll go inside the inspector panel of the sphere prefab. I'll then click on add component, and I will now search for the rotate sphere script. So in the search field, I'll type rotate, and as you can see, I'm getting this suggestion of a rotate sphere script. Okay, so I'll select it. So if you look over here, the rotate script is attached to the sphere prefab, and next, since all these spheres are created from the sphere prefab, if I click on sphere 1, then as you can see, the rotate sphere script is attached to sphere 1. If I click on sphere 2, the rotate sphere script is attached to sphere 2 as well. If I click on sphere 3 and sphere 4, then as you can see, the rotate sphere script is attached to sphere 3 and sphere 4 as well. Okay, so after attaching the script to all the sphere game objects, next, if I click on the play button, then as you can see, all the spheres are rotating together. Okay, so after this, I'll come out of play mode, and next, I'll change the x value to 0. I'll change the y value to 150. I'll save my script, and if I click on the play button, and now, as you can see, my sphere is rotating along the y-axis. Okay, similarly, if I change the y value to 0 and if I change the z value to 150, then at a z value of 150, you can see that the sphere is rotating like this. Okay, so I'll come out of play mode. And if you put some random values for x and z, okay, so I'll put some values and I'll save my script. And if you click on the play button, then now, as you can see, all the spheres are randomly rotating along the x, y, and z axis. Okay, so guys, that's it from this video, and I'll see you in the next video.